Which will get better results, Pelleve or Thermage treatment? Had a skin pinch but not satisfied yet with the result. Have under eye wrinkles that still bother me. What would you recommend, Pelleve or Thermage? I know laser and peel is more intense, but don't want the long downtime. Please advise. Thank you.
Thank you for your question. You submitted a question where you're asking which is better, Pelleve or Thermage, and you describe in your question that you've undergone skin pinch procedure, but you're still not satisfied with the appearance of your under eye wrinkles, and that you don't want to have the intensity of a laser and the prolonged healing time. And so naturally you're asking for what is the best option that meets your requirements. Well, I can certainly give you my perspective and tell you how I manage my patients in my practice. I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and fellowship-trained oculoplastic or oculofacial plastic surgeon practicing Manhattan and Long Island for over 20 years. And I've been performing CO2 laser since the mid-90s, since the introduction. And certainly have a lot of experience with thermal devices that with the goal of helping people improve the appearance of fine line and wrinkles for over 20 years. So let's start with just the issue that you're wrestling with at this point. You're clearly, after undergoing a skin pinch removal, you're no longer dealing with extra skin or redundant skin. You're dealing with a skin quality issue. So the thin quality of the skin. Now it's important to understand that the eyelid skin is only half a millimeter in thickness. That means you can only do so much to it. The skin is so thin, it's actually practically transparent when you realize what half a millimeter is. That being said, what is the principle that's being used when you apply heat to skin? Well, the principle is the skin will cause something, will respond by what's called collagen contraction or tightening, and you'll get some stimulation of more collagen that provides support. But I would say that when you think about eyelid skin, you have to think of the amount of the percentage of skin that is affected from the thermal energy and what kind of percentage is affected by anything that you do superficially. Now there's a point to that. The concern that you have about the prolonged downtime with CO2 laser is something that I've wrestled with for a long time. So years ago I started combining CO2 laser with platelet-rich plasma. Platelet-rich plasma is derived from your own blood, and it's a concentration of the growth and healing factors that are used in wound healing. So when you think about it, injecting platelet-rich plasma under the skin potentially can improve the skin quality and reduce the need for delivery of high doses of thermal energy. And in clinical practice, that's turned out to be very much the case. So in our practice, we actually combine not full ablative CO2, we don't do that often, but fractional CO2 laser. Fractional CO2 laser means less. There are fewer areas of ablation, and which means there's quicker healing, but still you deliver the columns of thermal energy to get contraction. Combining that with platelet-rich plasma, the skin quality not only improves, but the healing appears to improve as well. Bottom line is our patients look pretty good in about a week, and they're able to look even better as time goes on, and they get a more definitive result. There's a lot of popularity right now of non-surgical thermal devices, and slowly the pendulum is swinging the other way, as I had predicted years and years ago with the first thermal device introduction, is that people are overheating the skin. The technology, the practitioner, with the intent of tightening the skin, is actually overheating skin, resulting in tissue breakdown. So I would say that if your skin type is of a lighter skin type, you're better off with that strategy with the CO2 laser and PRP. And if you have a darker skin type, like when we see patients who have fine lines and wrinkles and their skin has more melanin, then actually we'll combine PRP with Pelleve. The reason I use Pelleve, and I chose Pelleve as the one thermal energy device that's non-ablative, is that I felt I had a lot more control, that I can gradually elevate the heat to a point where I can feel like I know how much heat I'm delivering and how much benefit I'll get. I can customize it and be conservative. A lot of thermal energy devices, like lasers, will promote their ability to deliver high energy. And of course, in a world where you think more is better, people always think more energy equals better results. But it's skating a very, very fine line. And once you cross that line, you get breakdown. And so now you hear more and more about complications of thermal energy devices which deliver a lot of heat. And we're seeing patients, and we're helping them to rehabilitate their skin by using platelet-rich plasma and other modalities to stimulate and restore, with regenerative medical technology, some of the health of their skin, because they've been literally overcooked. And unfortunately, when you deliver too much heat, not necessarily eyelid skin, which doesn't have much of anything resembling fat under the skin, in fact, it doesn't seem to have any of a fatty cell layer, but in other areas of the face, when you deliver thermal energy at a very high level, you're literally cooking the fat, and that fat is very important for the health of the skin. So in my practice, it's become routine to use PRP at the time we do laser, and then if we want to further enhance and improve the results, we can inject PRP again. PRP is something that's sustainable. You can't keep sustainably reheating the skin. This is a very common problem, again, with thermal energy devices. And not that the thermal energy itself has value in treating skin, but the judgment and the amount and the dose has to be the right amount and not too much. So I would suggest you explore this idea and accept a certain amount of downtime to get that improvement. Because when I was mentioning about ablation, you know, with a fractional CO2 laser, with the people of lighter skin color, just taking off that limited amount of the top layer of skin allows fresh new skin to come in that automatically looks better. You know, before there was CO2 lasers, there was chemical peels, and there's still chemical peels. And chemical peels benefit the skin by taking off the top layer and allowing a new layer of fresh, better quality skin to come in. That principle remains the same. And with non-ablative devices, you don't get that benefit. You can get improvement from the deeper level, at the dermis level, but at the epidermis, which is overlooked, and you may get some limitation from that respect. Of course, there are alternatives. We can use retinols and other things like that. So explore these options, and I hope that this was of value to you. So once again, I hope that was helpful, and thank you for your question.